Hi there, and welcome back to Azure This Week. Gwen isn't joining me today, I think. But don't worry, you'll see a lot more of her in 2021 right here on ACG. Now, this week's show includes Azure HealthBot is the new pandemic fighting tool. Yay! Chile gets its own region and data center, and Azure Monitor gets a couple of updates. Now, before I get into the news, it is shameless plug time! Yeah. In the next couple of weeks, ACG has two really awesome webinars. The first is the State of Cloud 2021, and the second one is with none other than Scott Hanselman on how you migrate your infrastructure to Azure. Now, both are free and available after the event as well, so check them out via the links in the description. The Microsoft Healthcare Bot has been helping people with patient management and engagement throughout the COVID-19 pandemic. Lots of healthcare providers and organizations have used the bot to create services that triage symptoms, answer common pandemic questions, locate facilities, and much more. It makes sense that the service is now moving to Azure and getting rebranded to Azure HealthBot. The migration is quick and simple, at least that's what's promised, and it means you can now integrate the Azure HealthBot with other Azure services, and it will comply with the enormous amounts of legislation and guidelines Azure does, as well as provide added security. Now, the bot comes with a bunch of predefined templates to get you going fast, and you can get started now! My prediction from last week about Azure growth is already proving to be correct. Yay! There's another new region coming to Azure, this time in Chile. Along with a new region and data centers, Microsoft is also committing to an upskill plan for 180,000 Chileans and an advisory board comprising local leaders to create inclusive opportunities to succeed in the digital economy. So those are Microsoft's words. Now, personally, I'm very happy to see more Azure expansion in South America, which has so far not got a lot of attention. The new region will support Azure, Microsoft 365, Dynamics 365, and Power Platform, but there is no firm date yet on when it might be up and running. Azure Monitor is one of those tools that rarely gets the glory, but system administrators use every day for a ton of configuration, adjustment, and troubleshooting. It is sometimes the real hero we need. This week, a couple of new features were announced in preview. First, there is an Azure Monitor workbook integration with application change analysis. This lets you create various types of charts using change data as a data source. And if you have tons of resources, this can come in real handy. Second, Azure Data Explorer clusters can now be monitored through Azure Monitor. This provides a range of benefits, which I won't list here, but check them out via the link in the description. That's it for the first real Azure news of 2021. Now, before I go, I did want to mention that A-Cloud Guru has been voted the number one place to work in Austin, Texas, which is where our US main office is. If you think that's awesome, give us a thumbs up. And as an added bonus, how about consider joining us? We need tons of talented people in all sorts of roles, and we would love to talk to you. As we say on the A-Cloud Guru team, when the boss has the day off and can't proofread the script for this week's episode, shriek and you shall proud. See you next week, and keep giving us thumbs up, Cloud Gurus.